This is the 40th video of Napoleon's Waterloo campaign, the wargaming of it. I am playing the French, and the game's artificial intelligence is playing the Prussians and the British. It is June 16th, 1815, 9:45 a.m. This is the morning of the dual battles opening the Waterloo campaign. I believe about 1 p.m. this day, Marshal Ney's attack against Quatre Bras begins, and like I think about 3 p.m. Napoleon's attack against the Prussians at Lannes occurs. It is turn 76 out of 388. We pull this timer out, and it's the French movement. Let's figure out where we've moved. Maybe we've moved everything. Looks like all this stuff has moved. Okay, let's go down here a ways. This is moved. This is moved. Looks like see if these guys moved. Yep. I'd say everything's moved. Next phase. Allied defensive fire. French offensive fire. None. French melee. None. Allied movement. Okay. There goes the furnace. Oh, look at this. Three skirmishers. A bunch more. There's a line unit there. Okay, looks like we're going to have a little fight. Guys waiting up here actually have nothing better to do, so it's a it's good timing. This guy's still disordered, so he'll have to move out of the way. Well, we'll put up the map elevations now, since we're going to have some action. Bunch of riffraff here. Two columns and two skirmishers. Supply unit. And the cavalry disappeared. And here we've got three supply units. Jesus, what is going on? We've got these three units. All right, we actually have some firing to do. This guy. 37 men. That's pretty good. Six, okay. And one. And of course everyone fires. And one. Allied melee. Alright, French movement. Let's move this guy to the side. Move him to the side. See how he likes these guys coming down. Like I said, we've got nothing better to do. These guys are just waiting, probably for about 10 more turns until they can get on the road. Oh, just send them down here. Should be enough. We'll see how things develop. Now, let's go up to the top here. Where did he go? We'll find out sooner. Oh, there he is. Okay. Let's turn up. Charge. And we'll continue to reorganize here. Let's make some room. This is really helpful to reorganize. Not only do you get the units of your brigades and divisions back together and in command control, but any fatigue you have starts to wear off as you're stationary, as well as your morale will start to improve if you've been beaten down. So a lot of good things happen. Okay. These guys. Kind of put over here. Second corps there. Fourth corps. Second corps. Second corps is up here, isn't it? Yep. It's fourth corps. Fourth corps. Fourth Corps, okay. Those colors are the same. Third Corps, which I believe is right there. Yep. First Corps. Right there. Second Corps. Straight up. Second Corps. First Corps. Third Corps, first, second. Third. Wait a minute, that's second. Okay, second Corps. First, where's third? Here's third. We'll put this division down here. Both third. And here's more third. This is third. I guess these guys are all third. Well, I don't have to worry. There's no more cutoffs now, so I just move straight up. Yeah, unfortunately, as with the last several turns, the turn is going to be like 99% movement. It's the nature of redeploying. Let's see, for the heck of it, what the victory conditions look like. Okay, major victory. About 6,500 French losses and about 30,000, 31,000 it looks like, allied, so. AI has the bad habit of splitting up a unified force into several pieces, and then each piece decides to act as a raider. The only problem is the French are moving in a compact mass, so if a raider shows up, they just siphon off a half a dozen units or more to deal with it. So the raiders are really not that much of a threat if you can see them coming. If they're hiding in the woods, that might be different, but they're by nature, in order to catch the French, they have to move on good roads, and good roads Yeah, sometimes they go through the woods, but a lot of times they're in the clear. And visibility here is 20 hexes, so far I've always seen them coming and can prepare. But you can see they're scattered all over the place, three, four, five units. Jesus, if you mass those five separate forces together, you'd have a decent force, but yeah, I keep scattering them all over the place, thinking there's some advantage in that. I like to concentrate things. Jeez, what's going on here? Let me look down here. Whoa, all open ground behind, huh? Well, that's real interesting, I think. Shit. Let's see if we can send this guy this way. I think we'll send some cavalry around there, why not? Where's the road? Shit, kind of a long road, but cavalry moves fast. We can get on that open ground. Maybe we can trap them. Like I said, these guys aren't doing anything anyway, except sitting here. Might as well give them some exercise. Okay. I think we'll bring out some artillery here. Let's move these guys closer. Blast this guy back. See if we can unlimber him. Nope. Maybe next time. Meanwhile, we will continue on. Now, three skirmishers. Mounted. So the guy will work his way over here. And just in case these guys want to go in the woods. All right. That'll be enough to take care of them. We'll just keep moving on. Let's turn him down. We can't. Yeah, we can. He's got movement. All right. So we'll see what they'll be able to do. My prediction is nothing except get killed. Meanwhile, these guys will keep moving north. See, when you got all your army concentrated along a road, it's not very hard to just slough off some units every once in a while, or leaving the others to keep going down the road. I ever get. No, he's in 32 men, nothing to brag about, but still he recovered from disorder, so. A lot of gaps between these units. Normally I'd tighten them up, but I'm more concerned to keep moving going north and finally leave him behind, both the British and the Prussians. No kidding. All right. This guy's never going to catch up. So there's no one else back there. That being the case, I can withdraw these guys. Now, he can have the road. Okay. Let's check out this way, my scouts. Let's get rid of these map elevations. Oh, supply units got in back of me, huh? I do believe I can charge that guy. Oh, he won't. Oh, God damn it, I'm in the woods. I think I can melee him anyway. Yeah, if you're in the woods, you can't implement a charge. Okay, ally defensive fire. Oh, he's got more guys coming up here. Okay. French offensive fire. Bang bang, 43. How do you like that? And now French melee. Where is that bastard? There he is. See what kind of odds I can get. Automatic victory, good. Doesn't matter if I charge or not. Boom, so that's one. Now it's mine. All he's got is supply units. Good luck. Okay. Allied movement. Now what's he gonna do? This guy's probably gonna push through the woods. Oh, he is coming out. And deploying here. How interesting. I'm afraid of all these skirmishers. He's got this guy coming out of the woods right in front of my cavalry. Who is he? Infantry. Okay. Hope he's on a clear hex. I'm not set up to charge him, but I will be. Actually, I might as well move the rest of this infantry down. Because all he can do is go in the woods. Now what happened to these guys? Pushing them further and further up here, and this is shitty terrain up here. Oh, going through the woods, that's wise. Unfortunately, it's going to take you 10 turns to get to the woods. French defensive fire. Well, we go up to Croix de Bras because that's where we're having the action now. He's in column too. Well, we can't charge him. Well, we can fire at this guy. Skirmishers, 8 men. I think that's it for the firing. Allied offensive fire. Okay, 3 men. Two. Four. Allied melee. Okay, French movement. Well, let's deploy here. See how we're gonna do this. Start deploying. See how you like that. This guy's still disordered. Something tells me those skirmishers aren't going to get through. Set up for a charge here. And we'll bring these guys down. Why not? Got nothing better to do with them. Sure, this guy's gonna take to the woods, which is fine. We'll proceed on our way and then we'll send these guys into the woods after him. Okay, that takes care of them. Now let's go up to the top. Oh, where did this guy go, I wonder? Let's tiptoe up here, see if we can find him. Oh. Going through there, is he? Okay. This is second core. Second core. Get these leaders out here. First core. They're the purples. Second core. Second core. First core. So who does he belong to? First core. Third core, which is there. Third core. Third core. Let's put the leader. Oh, that's all I can go. Third core. Third Cavalry Corps. Well, finally, we've got some cavalry from the Cavalry Corps. Shit. They want to move that. It's purple, that's a different color. So is this. These leaders sorted out. Jesus, that looks like a dark blue. Here's a purple. That looks the same as this. That looks like this. A lot of leaders in this deck. Okay. Core. Oh, Imperial Guard. I'll just get on, just keep going north. Well, we're slowly getting things sorted out here. Now, who's bigger? He's in column. That's not too good. 372, 475. He'll charge. Supply unit to block them. This guy will go out in the open where he can set up for a charge. Okay. This was not a good idea for them to stay out in the open like that. Because we're going to charge them. Maybe they forgot what happens when cavalry charges skirmishers. Nothing good for the skirmishers. Okay, let you take care of them. Now, just in case we have anyone else tiptoeing in here, and we do. I knew it. Okay. He's gonna fan out this scum so he can cut the road somewhere. Well, it's not gonna be that easy. And all the while, we continue moving north without interruption, so far anyway. With this guy, I should check out the woods over here. There's probably some more vermin hiding in there. I'm just about done for today. Only got another minute. Oh, this guy recovered. Can pull this guy in. Oh, this guy, I can pull him in. Okay, that'll be it for today.